So much for the much ballyhooed pitching matchup between Irvin Santana of the Twins and Chris Sale of the Red Sox. Santana had allowed only 3 runs in his first 41 innings, but today he allowed 4 runs in just 4 innings. He is human after all. But it was the bullpen which let them down late as Boston's offense came to life these past 2 days and bullied their way past the Twins, 17-6. Santana faced the always pesky Dustin Pedroia hit a home run to give the Sox a quick 1-0 lead. Irvin Santana began the day with the lowest earned run average in the majors, 0.66. It got worse still in the first. Andrew Benintendi hit a rocket out into the plaza in right field, a 2-run homer. And Santana had to be wondering what in the world was going on. Red Sox already up 3-0. Chris Sale was doing his part for Boston, leading the majors in strikeouts. He had 10 more over his 6 innings, but the Twins, who have had success against him, they made Sale throw a lot of pitches in the fifth. And they put up 4 runs to tie it. The key hit, Jorge Polanco's 2-run single. Kenny Vargas followed with a sacrifice fly, and the game was tied 4-all. But in the top of the sixth, likely Santana's last inning with 2 outs, Sandy Leon golfed one, which kept carrying and out of the park for a 2-run homer. The Sox extended the lead 7-4. Vargas homered. It was 7-6. But the Red Sox blew it open in the ninth with 10 more runs. Yep, 10 runs in a never-ending ninth inning. Sox win it 17-6. The Twins are off tomorrow, opening a series on Tuesday in Chicago against the White Sox. After the game, manager Paul Molitor said it was too bad they couldn't complete the comeback.
There was a lot of good things about the game. We made a mistake on the changeup on the 2-run homer to put them back in front, and we had a chance there in the eighth inning to get back to even, came up a little bit short. And then, like you said, it got a little bit ugly at the end. But, series overall, I think there was a lot of good things about it.
The biggest upset and best performance in the short history of Minnesota United, shutting out first place Sporting Kansas City, 2-0 in front of a celebratory crowd on this beautiful afternoon at TCF Bank Stadium. What an MLS debut for the Loons' first overall draft pick, Abu Dunlady, from Ghana, who was set up on a beautiful crossing pass from Miguel Ibarra. And just like that, it was in the back of the net. Dunlady came over to the United States as a teenager to play soccer. Kansas City had allowed the fewest goals in the league, just 3, and Minnesota United has had issues scoring, but they were on the mark today. Ibarra did it again on his second assist of the day, as fan favorite Christian Ramirez connected on a header, and Minnesota was up 2-0. Kansas City was 5-1-3 coming in, but this was a great win for the Loons, and we are seeing what should be a great rivalry over the years. Goalie Bobby Shuttleworth got the shutout, playing on despite suffering a broken nose. Final score was 2-0, Minnesota United with a big win. 2 weeks ago, the Minnesota Wild's postseason ended with a thud, losing at home to the St. Louis Blues in 5 games in the opening round of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Unfortunately for head coach Mike Yeo and the Blues, they met their match with a very good Nashville Predators team, getting eliminated this afternoon in Nashville. The Blues came out like the desperate team they were. 2 minutes into the first period, it's Paul Stastny converting a shot off the stick of Vladimir Tarasenko. St. Louis was able to exhale for a bit, grabbing a 1-0 lead. It stayed that way until the first shift of the second period when Nashville's Roman Josi beat goalie Jake Allen of the Blues. And 35 seconds into the second period, we had a tie game, 1-1. And it remained that way. Early in the third period, Nashville got the 2-on-1 break. And Ryan Johansson went to his backhand at the last second, cleanly beating Jake Allen, and the Predators were up 2-1. St. Louis had to pull its goalie, and Nashville made them pay for it, getting the clincher on the open net goal, winning the game 3-1, and the series 4-2. They have never advanced to the conference finals. Anaheim can clinch the other Western Conference semifinal series with a win at Edmonton tonight. Otherwise, there will be a game 7 on Wednesday back in Edmonton. That's your look at sports. We'll be right back.